Welcome to another great episode of Crypto Jargon, the series where I break down the complex terms that we use in reference to blockchain technology and cryptocurrencies. In this episode, what is BFA, Keylogger, Phishing, Trojan, DDoS, and Cryptojacking? What all of these have in common is that they are all forms of cyber attacks, hacking in one way or another. I'll explain, stay tuned. This episode is sponsored by Ledger, the maker of the best hardware wallets on the market. Their devices support more than 1,000 different crypto assets, so you can safely store all of your tokens and coins in a robust cold storage and truly be the owner of your private keys and have the best protection against hackers. To find out more about it, check out the description of the video where you will find the link and my tutorials on the Ledger Nano S and Ledger Nano X devices. So let's get started with BFA, which stands for Brute Force Attack. This is an attack where someone tries to find a code, key or password by using trial and error methods. For instance, if a password is a 4-digit code, a brute force attack in simple terms would be to try 4 zeros, then 0001, 0002, 0003 and so on. But of course, brute force attacks are carried out by automated software, so they don't actually take as much effort as you would need if handled manually. And they can be very dangerous and quite successful, especially with weak passwords. Speaking of passwords, a word of advice. Many crypto-related websites are now allowing you to have a space between the words in your password and also special characters. So make sure that you use this to make your password more complex and never use the same password for two or more websites. Moving on to Keylogger, this is a tool designed to capture all keystrokes of a computer, either through a software program or through a hardware device. Often it is used to hack into accounts by recording passwords. This keyboard recording activity is also referred to as keylogging or keystroke logging. Next one on my list is phishing. This is a type of attack in which a malicious website, company or an individual presents themselves as a trustworthy in an attempt to fool the victim into giving up personal information such as login details, passwords, credit card details, bank details and many others. This is one of the most widespread and common cyber attack techniques, and usually it comes in the form of an email, supposedly by a respected company, with a request or a warning about the purchase on your account, or some other form of alert for you to open a link and check your account activity. Well, that link is most certainly a fraudulent one, and if you get fooled into clicking on it, you will most certainly compromise your login details and much more. We've all seen those emails about Amazon gift card purchase or iTunes purchase or sometimes PayPal and many other popular services that are being imitated in these phishing emails, simply because these are services used by the majority of us online. Always check the sender of the email in case you get tempted to even read these emails. I usually ignore them, but every now and then I would open one of these and I will see that even though the sender at first glance seems to be Apple or Amazon or whatever else you have there, this is not the real sender. It is just how the email is being masked to fool me into opening it in the first place. But as I scroll over the actual sender, I can see that it's not a real company email address. Next is Trojan. This is a type of malware that is often disguised as legitimate software. Trojans can be employed by cyber thieves and hackers to gain access to users' systems. They are typically tricked into loading and executing Trojans on their systems, so once activated, they can enable cyber criminals to spy on you, steal your sensitive data, and gain backdoor access to your system. These actions can include deleting data, blocking, modifying or copying data, and all kinds of disrupting the performance of a computer. Okay, moving on to DDoS, which stands for Distributed Denial of Service. It aims to crash servers and make websites temporarily disappear until the attack can be traced and halted. A DDoS attack begins when the attacker rounds up hundreds of zombie computers. This is achieved by downloading Trojans and viruses onto remote computers without the owner knowing. Once the zombie network is in place, The attacker targets one website, email server or network and directs all of the zombie computers to flood the victim with tasks or requests, which crashes their system. Several cryptocurrency exchanges have been the targets of DDoS attacks, which are often politically or personally motivated. In order to avoid such an infestation, computer owners should download up-to-date security software that searches their systems for malware and spyware. Malware, by the way, is just a common term for any kind of malicious software. And lastly, cryptojacking, which became a thing back in 2017, and throughout 2018 it spread out to all kinds of devices, even mobile phones and tablets. This is a term, a combination of two other terms, crypto mining and hijacking, and is the process of remotely using or hacking into someone else's computer without their knowledge or permission in order to mine cryptocurrencies. Monero was the often cryptocurrency of choice, and the Pirate Bay was one of the first well-known websites that began using this method in order to bring in additional revenue aside from their numerous pop-ups and annoying banners. Cryptojacking is quite dangerous for your device because it drains the battery or generally reduces the performance of your device, computer, mobile device, tablet, whatever you have. I actually dedicated a separate video to cryptojacking where I'm explaining it in more detail, so check out the description box where I will have the link for that one. Enjoying this content? Why not grab a copy of my book Cryptojargon A to Z, the most thorough dictionary that exists to date, with over 700 definitions of acronyms, trading slang and all the crypto terminology you need. Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today.
And one more thing.
Announcing my special summer giveaway. Yes, to celebrate the arrival of summer, I'm doing a special summer giveaway on my YouTube channel for all of my subscribers. I'd like to get to know you better and I want your feedback on my content. In return, I'm giving away not one, not two, but 10 great prizes. 5 physical Revolut debit cards. Revolut is an online bank with zero fee conversion of all major currencies, including Bitcoin and Ethereum, and it's my favorite card to use on my travels. Also, I'm giving away crypto prizes: $50 worth of Bitcoin, $50 worth of Ethereum, $25 worth of Litecoin, and $25 in Dash. And the grand prize, my favorite hardware wallet device, the Ledger Nano S. Compact, secure, and anonymous, the Ledger Nano S is everything you need to store safely your long-term crypto holdings. For your chance to win, all you have to do is like and comment on my videos from now until August, when I will select the winners. You also have to be a subscriber, of course, but it's free to subscribe, so this is your chance to win these fantastic prizes. You are in charge with your luck. The most active subscribers will be rewarded. It's that easy, so get busy.